Okay, oh, my voice works good. Okay, just checking. Wow, it's amazing. So we all have fears, yep. Mine was public speaking. Still is a little, but I'm getting better. When I found out we had to do a diamond speech, I wanted to quit. That was it. That was the day in the first couple of weeks. But little did I know that I was going to be speaking heaps over the next 18 months. I remember sitting in the audience in Sydney, much like all of you, watching the diamond speeches. That was my favourite part. That's something I love about this business. We have to push out of our comfort zone and face our fears. But the main reason I'm up here today is to show people that anyone can do this. Anyone. Anyone. And I want to give massive thanks to the team. We all know this is never done alone. It's a team effort. The team is made up of uplines, downlines, and sidelines. So let me share a little bit about myself. One of seven children, so the only girl. Growing up was very interesting. When I look back, I feel like my childhood was my training to become a network marketer. It was a tough gig, but I wouldn't change a thing. I didn't have much of an education. My first year of high school, I was very sick, so I missed about the first 6 months of the year of year seven. This set me up to put me very behind. So I spent year eight and nine in the principal's office because I didn't understand anything. So mucking around was, I was covering up for that. I realised this later in life, that's what I was doing. I told Mum that. I only lasted the first term of year 10. So I really feel like I didn't have much of an education. Fast forward 20 years, when all of my boys were at school, I was looking for something else to do. My husband and I had a traditional business in construction for 15 years. And while I did some sales, accounts, and admin, I wanted something more. I knew there was something else that was out there for me. But I soon realised that I needed to have skills behind me to really get a job. So I'd enrolled in a course, I got accepted, and it was all sorted. This was last year. So how did I get up here? Well, it was when I was getting a spray tan off my beauty therapist. She told me about this new mask that I had to try. It was amazing. I said yes right away. I love trying new products and I had hormonal acne and rosacea. I loved it after the first night. Just a few weeks later, I was invited to her home to see more about these products. I was really intrigued. Now, this presentation was on the day I was due to pay my course fees. I didn't get down there that day. I was really busy. So I just thought, I'll go the next day. That's cool. So I went that night to the presentation. I was surrounded by strangers. I didn't know anybody there. I sat in her lounge room with about 20 other people. In front of me was a lady named Nikki Zarnecki. Yeah. She presented the products and the business, and I was blown away by this opportunity. I couldn't wait for her to stop talking so I could sign up. True, yeah. I'd already loved the mask, and I was looking for something to do in my life, so it seemed perfect. Whilst our construction business was exactly where we wanted it to be, we were really tired, and it was taking its toll on our family. So that's why I jumped on this, because I knew we needed a plan B. All I had to do was share this with people. I was down with that. So I went home, and I said to my husband, I know this sounds crazy, but I've just seen the most amazing thing, and I know it's what I need to do. I just know it. I left out the part about spending $700 on a pack. Yeah. So in one day, the entire course of our lives, it changed. It was all based on a gut feeling. I didn't really know anyone apart from the beauty therapist, so everybody was a stranger at the start, but I knew it was what I was looking for. So right away, I went about sharing this with my close friends and family. So many people said no, but you know, a few said yes, and that's all I needed. Here we are today. Now, was it easy? No way. I've made plenty of mistakes, face plants by the truckload, and the days where I doubted myself. Lots of fails. It's pretty normal. If you don't have days like that, then you're not doing the business properly. Don't be afraid to dream, to fail big or dream big, because dreams without goals are just dreams. And ultimately, they have disappointment. So have dreams, but have goals too. To really achieve these, you have to be consistent and you have to work at it. Don't get me wrong, I had so many days where I doubted myself, I couldn't count them. We can be our own worst enemy. The stories that we tell ourselves could destroy our dreams and goals. This was a major struggle that I had. And to be honest, I still do. It's something that I have to fight for. Something that has been ingrained in me for so long that had been my normal for 38 years. It's just how I am. I'm sure many of you can relate. It's getting better as I grow. But that's the beauty of this business. You start to realize that you can achieve something. Anything, actually. If you choose to, you can do it. Being consistent has been the one thing that has allowed me to ride those waves of doubt and days spent in the valley. Yeah, I'm halfway. Oh. I've learned so much. I first heard the saying, if it's to be, it's up to me, about 12 months ago, and I'd never heard that before. I was mesmerized by it, actually. It was really profound, and I kept thinking, wow, if it's to be, it's up to me. I would chant that in my head. So if I want this to work, I have to make it happen. I can't blame anyone else. I can't expect anybody else to do it for me. I needed to do it. That was a massive aha moment for me. What about the sacrifice? Well, my vision was pretty big from the start, but I knew that I'd have to sacrifice things to get there. So everyone is running their own race. You have to always remember that. You can never compare yourself to others, as everyone has a different journey. But for me, we had to make this work within a deadline. So we set a goal. And while this did put a lot of pressure, it was the best thing that we ever did. So when I talk about sacrifice, for me, it was time away from my family. Time on the phone, calls, Zooms, messaging. This was hard on my boys. They'd always had mum around. They weren't used to me being out of the home or just preoccupied. I only had one other person doing this in my town, so I had to travel a lot, so 4 to 6 hours away. That's where everybody else was. So often spent 2 or 3 nights away at a time. That was really hard, really hard. But it was worth it. The end goal was always very clear. So that's what got me through. Watching all my friends go away on family holidays was hard, but we chose to invest our money that we made back into the business. Costs for travel, trips to events, lots of personal development, and other things that would give me the skills that I needed to become better in any way I could. But it was worth it. Sacrifice is a huge part of success. It can hurt, but it's worth it. I'm sure most people here can relate that you don't always earn a great income in the beginning. It takes time. So sometimes it feels like you're working for free. We're always spending more than we're making. But I was always told, thanks Marty, the work you do now, you'll get paid on later. It always sounded weird though. I don't get that. When will I get paid? But I kept going. And after about 12 months, I started to see that come true. And now I say that all the time. If your belief is not strong, that's when a lot of people quit. That's one of the hard parts of this business, to keep going when you feel that way. Don't let the doubt set in. That's why giving this a good crack and investing in yourself is so important to be successful. It's hot under these lights. You have to push through the hard to get to the good, but that feeling when you get there is out of this world. The sense of accomplishment is something I've never felt on such a big scale. So that's my story, enough about me. The time, 11 seconds, no way. I timed this, okay, a shout out, So the team, first up is the team. Without every single one of you, this does not happen. Thank you for growing with me. In those early days, especially when we were all so new, you know, I made mistakes, face plants, We got through it. The friendship we have is more than business. You know it. We always make sure that we don't take ourselves too seriously. I look forward to where you're all going, and I can't wait to share all your achievements with you. We really do have way too much fun to call this work. To the founders and corporate team, thanks for your passion and belief in all of us. Every time I hear you speak, it cements my belief even further. You always put our needs first and do what you can to help our businesses grow. Marty and Nath, you give belief to people. When we look at the girl in the thongs on the stage, we realise we can do it. Thank you for believing in us. Nikki, we were strangers in the beginning, but I'm grateful for everything that you did for me, especially in the beginning, in those early months. You lead from the front. You showed me how to listen to people so I could help them and show them what this could do for them. Thank you. I learnt that from you. Paula, you have the emotional strength to help people through the valley, especially me. Lots of moments there. Your caring nature and product knowledge is amazing, and you serve so many people I can't even count. AK, you helped me in my darkest days in this business. You never judged me, you always knew exactly what to say, and you give everything to the team and never say no to helping someone in need. Steffi, my battle buddy. She was there for the highs and the lows. When no one showed up to our presentations, and we'd sit around eating the platter afterwards, trying not to be disheartened. We have so many stories from our road trips, and even more now since we've had the tea. Many more to come. It's true. You know me too well. It's a pain sometimes, but you really know when to bring me back to the surface. We've been friends for 15 years, but we are like sisters now. Jeremy, without you, I would not have been able to do this the way that I've done it. It's not always easy, and we've had some hard moments to get through. You sacrificed your business sooner than planned so we could give this everything and you could be there for our boys. Knowing they had you in my place made it easier for me. But when I look back now, it's been the best thing for our family. And your cooking skills are out of this world. To our three boys, Bailey, Dylan and Harley, you've been amazing. Even through the tough times when I was away a lot and you didn't really understand what I was trying to do, we have more time now as a family. We can go away whenever we want without pressures of work and deadlines. It's an amazing feeling. So many more, but my time is up ages ago. So just take one thing at least away from this conference, because this is where it happens. And go home and make it a reality. It's up to you, you can do it. The community is huge. Take a look around this room and see. Go and talk to everyone. You'll never find a single person that's had it easy, I guarantee it. Thank you.